Hello everyone, welcome to Arthral Studio. This is Anuja and today we are going to do a Kalamkari side view profile of the faces. So that is something that we have not done so far and we would be finishing our program this day and later we will be starting up with another program, another course and another workshop, all happening on the weekends, Saturdays and Sundays. So if you all can view me and hear me, please type a yes so that I can start. Okay. I would be putting my good Happy Teacher's Day to everyone who is present here. Everyone, we teach somebody or the other. Our children are there, we as parents are teaching them. So, Teacher's Day to all of you. Happy Teacher's Day. Today we are going to start with the side view of the figure. So, we have already done the Ganesha, the Lakshmi and the side view, the Krishna, the front view. Now, today we are going to do how to do the side profile of the face. That also is seen in many of the paintings. So, I will fix it to my table and then I will show you. Yesterday we did the painting and I want to share that with you. I'll just adjust it and I did a little bit with the pen and this is how it came. So this is all solely with the pen. So for pen I used a pentel. I would advise you, if you want to do the painting as well on the background, then you can use a waterproof pen. You get uniball colors and micron color pens. Any pen is okay. I used the brush for only the side of it. And this is how the picture came. So it is not always that we create very, very bright colors. Sometimes we only do the line work and it comes out beautifully. So this is how. I'm somehow happy with this. I'm very happy with this outcome. And I loved it. So those who have this hitch of using the colors, who are not very comfortable, can use the lining and you will see that the shades are, we can catch up with the shades of this picture. Now today, I am using the paper. Many people ask me what paper do I use. So I use Brustro drawing. It's a heavyweight it's the glare is there. It's Brustro drawing heavyweight medium surface, means the surface is not very rough, not very smooth. So it is very good and it is 200 GSM. So that is app, that is okay for if you want to do the coloring also or you want to do the drawing. So I have taken one sheet of it. This sheet is the A4 size paper. The pen I am using is a waterproof pen. You may use a pencil, any pencil, if a mechanical pencil or a regular pencil is okay. So either of the pencils and one eraser if you feel that you might go wrong at places. So just to check that. So here I will be starting with the two faces here. I'm putting the picture like this and let's see how it turns out to be. So for male and female, I'll be making two faces here. I'm taking a pencil to just chalk out where I will be doing a male face. So I'm just going freehand to make a circle. And this is the place where I'll be doing the male face and here a female face. Okay, or rather you can just see to it that the corners are the same. It's just a very rough outline. You may just use, I'm not doing the circle anywhere. That's not in the program. I'm just plotting it where it will be. So I'm starting with the male figure and I will lower the camera so that you get a good view of it. So here. How would we determine where the face is? I will be taking the side view and the side view will be this way, and this is the hair part, and this is the, so this is kind of a face I will be doing, and I will start directly with the pen. I hope you got the guideline. That's how the face is going to be placed. I will directly start with, so here is a placement of the kundal. And this is how like this. I don't know, I'm not able to view any of the chats right now, if in case you are asking any questions. Okay, let me see if I can resume the chat. Here, this sideways, the face is big and this will also be big. I'm just giving it a little more detail. Here. So, just giving you the idea how we do it. So, if we were doing the front face, then also we used to do these in the sides and this in the, and the face was here. So, probably when it is a front face, it will have this decorations like this. But here, just imagine that is not there. We are just drawing the one side of it. Just doing the double to make it a little bigger. This is the side. So it's a pointy design over here. I hope you're able to see it well. For this side, this is the place where the hair is. Just imagine that you are, if I cover this portion, you will feel that it is just having in an angle. Otherwise, it looks as if the full face is there. Doing the ear. And making the hair. Just making a curve here. And covering the side of the ear. Now the side around the ear. Now I just make these twirls and I'm attaching them here. This way. Double line. And three layers. You can have the design of the crown. This is the crown. This is the filling of the side. I will be ending the design right here. So far we are done with this. Now I will be doing the face. The forehead in the same angle. Then a small depression in the nose. We will see that the nose is very pointed. Lips. And then the chin. We'll see that the chin is made and then it is attached like this. So kind of a double chin kind of effect that is there. So this is the side view of the face. Now, depending on how you want to make it, if we are making it as a lady, definitely the mukut size will be a little feminine, it will be a little different. You will see that this arch, this sharpness of the eyebrow bone will not be that sharp. The nose will be also soft and the chin will also be soft. So the comparative study I will be doing, and then you will see the male, how we do the line drawing for male figure. So putting it as a tikka, depending on what tikka you want to give. Like that. Eyebrow. For such kind of drawings, we see that the eyebrows and the eyes are big. Before I'm making the eyebrow. Filling it with the top. This. I hope you all are liking it. If you are liking the video, do press the like and I will get to see that. So the eye. Now it is your wish that whether you want to keep one line above or you want to make it in a fish way. Fish cut is like we do the bow to the lid. This we can extend it here. For this one, I'm not doing it that way. I'm just doing one side. I'm doing another lid. And then I will be doing the eyeball. When we do the eyeball, I will be taking a small dot to show the shine of the on the eye. And I'll be filling up all the space here with black. It's my personal liking to do the a little double line for the eyelid, the top eyelid. It gives a very beautiful look to the picture. So it is your wish if you want to do the upper eyelid a little dark. So this is here. If you want to make it a young man or a boy or any prince, then you may not give a very big mustache. But if you are doing it as a king or some character which has a mustache, then you can just put it like this. The end corner of the lip will not be visible because it will be covered. And then you can have the desired grooming, okay, for whichever way you want, how heavy you want the mustache to be, you can just do it. Color it total black. There is one more thing. This looks very calm and peaceful, nice. If we do the characters which are negative, then we add few more things. We keep it, the eyebrows is not curved, it is kind of straight, that gives a frowning look. This curve gets to be curved more. So I'm doing it in pencil because I don't want it to look like that. I'm doing it with a lady, so I'll keep the grays on. So here, that's it. And now the neck. I'll take the center and do the neck here. We do the fold of the chin in the first in the front face also. We do it in the middle, but now here we have taken it from one side like this. And I will do the neck piece because Maharajas or these characters, if they are so adorned with it. And this is the fabric that they tie. You may also do the hair. Multiple layers to show the bands, and then the U kind of design. You may add a pendant to it. See to it that the pendant comes in the middle. So middle means it will fall in the front, because this is the line of the front. Like that. So this is our character here. I don't know what had happened. I cannot see your comments here or your likes here in the chat box. I'm not able to take your doubts also. So I would advise that you write it in the comment section of the video, of the live, and then I will revert you back. So giving it, it's looking as if it's an old king. So here I'll just do the dark on the hair here. You may also use, I'll just quicken it by using a brush pen. And there, I'll just get the fine line. So when we are making the Ram Darbar or anything, we will see that these, this is quite royal otherwise. Otherwise, we will see a lot of attendants also. The face will be the same. It's only that the decorations and the detailing gets a little less. Now, if you are doing a god or a goddess, then we do that circle also. And then it comes like this. I will just give a little of it, but like this. So that thing also gets added to the face, the curve that we have done in the previous one. So here, now coming back to the lady here, this side. I hope it's visible now. So we will follow the same size. We will follow the same size, and now I will sketch it. Definitely we'll not give it that height, and how it will change the thing. We'll take the same, because I'm just doing a comparison. I don't want the faces to be a little up and down. So I'll just do the reference from here. The face is not that broad. I'll finish it up here. And this is the, like we did the front of the face, we are doing the front for the for this as well. And this is the hair, this is the ear, and this is the, so this I got the basic structure of my face. I will be going ahead with this, right? So you'll feel all the details coming up with the pen. So the first thing that I would do is the earring. Now I will change the designs slightly towards a little more feminine size, more flowers and more beads for this side. Oh yeah, I got all the chat here. And good. Thank you, Archana. Yes, now today, how many sessions I'm taking? This is the last thing that was left, is the side profile, and I wanted to cover it today. In the next week, we are going to do another workshop. You will get the update of it. Okay. So this is the last, because this was not covered in it, and we cannot finish it off halfway. So that this is our last day of Kalamkari. This. Now I'm giving it a little pointed petals. Now here you will see that this and this gets changed. Small design variation. Like this. I'm just giving the same scallop design covering the tips. Oh ma'am, aap nahi dikh rahe ho. Oh sorry, it is. Thank you, Shanti. Thank you for your subscription. Okay, sorry, main nahi dikh rahi ho. I have placed myself also. Now here, since this is here, and I will be making one flower over here as well. So this is the side of the face, and I'm just beautifying it just like I did this part here. Thank you everyone. आप लोगों को अच्छा लग रहा है तो जरूर एक लाइक दीजिए, so that I get to see it later. कोई भी doubts हैं तो write it in the chat box. I'm there to help you out. Because clear all your doubts that you might have. Because today we will be ending the Kalamkari. So by the end of this, once we are done, I will attend to all your questions and I will answer it. So here is the ear. Now for this, I'm adding one small accessory that they wear in this area of this ear here. And now I am giving the design of the hair. I'm just giving a little wiggly kind of design, like curls. And thereafter, giving a small difference, you will see that this is a curl over here, and this is kind of a small, a little longer one. These smaller details will create a lot of variation, and that will instantly, you will see how feminine the character comes. So now I will be doing the front of the face. And this is the side, the chin is also like this. I will give the small thickness down there. So this is gone here. The curve of the chin is also gone. Now instead, we will just add a small dimple kind of a thing here. Kerala mural is very different, Alka. We will start Kerala mural also. Kerala mural has the choice of colors are very limited, and the style is also a lot different. So this is very different from that. So giving the cover of the head. Now this time, for this, I'm creating a little small variation. I will not be adding this crown here so that you get to do the hairstyle as well. So for any dancer or for any female figure who is not wearing, and if not a goddess, they will not have those crowns and all. How would you do it? So this is a... whatever you can call it, it's Mount Tika or a small tiara kind of a stuff. This is just an accessory for the hair. Now I'm extending it till this part. Giving a flower on the hair. Now, coming back to the face here, let's finish off the face and then we'll start the accessory. A tikka, bindi, you can make it big or small. The eyebrow, very relaxed. Now here I will show you the double. So it is up and down. This is how we do it. I'll just extend it a little. I'll just make the heavy outline for the eye that shows big, cool eyes. And then the eyeball. I'll again leave the white dot over here and fill up. Like this. I'm adding a nut. Here. Thank you. this. Now I'll be covering the, we can do the choti and we can also do the, ma'am is using waterproof pens. Yes, I'm using a waterproof pen. Thank you, Meg. You can, if it is only for the drawing, you can make it with a black gel pen also if you don't want to color it. Now here I'm adding a juda, and juda just starting where the eye is starting, I'm ending it where the hair. Don't have to place it very low because it has to be stuck where the hairline is. The hair ends on the before the neck. So this is the structure of it. Here I will create some nice designs for flowers and whatever the accessories there is. So we can have the juda cover with such designs. You can add multiple strands. Multiple strands, and then maybe the beads in the hair, whatever your liking is, you can accessorize the picture the way you want. Now here I'm adding this. This finishes this side of it. Coming to the lower part here, the neck. You may also add a small tiara kind of thing here, which can be very similar to this. So we see some have those kind of decorations, so I'll just show you the variation with this. If in case you want to add this, you can add it here. Just add it like this and then decorate it. You may also add a little more and then that's it. So depends on the design that you want to do. Here, now. This. Alka, it will come. It don't get disheartened. It will happen. I also learned it. You can also learn it. It will happen. Just a little more practice. That's it. So don't feel that only I am able to do and yours is not coming that well. It might not come the first time, but it will come. No worry. I'm just making it a little elaborate to match with this, because here if I see the proportions, this is very big and this is a little. I just want to add a little bit more and then we will be finishing with this. This way. So this is the picture here. We have to still do the hair, which will take some time because if in case we are doing it with this, I will take the brush and I can also use the ink, the waterproof ink. I have a waterproof ink. I will be filling it up, the hair with that. And I'll show you the final outcome of the side view. Any questions that you have, you can write it down and I will. Nib size, what are you using? It is not the nib, it is just a pen and it is about like a 0.7, 0.7. So if you want bolder lines, you can take for a 0.7, that will be good. Here I'm taking a waterproof ink to do the hair. I'll just show you. It's camel waterproof drawing ink. You can also make your own drawing ink. If you do not have this, you can make all colors of drawing ink by using acrylic paints. I have a video on that which is posted on my channel. You can review there and you will know the proper consistency and how to make it work with brush also and with nib also. So with the waterproof ink, I'll just fill the hair so that it gets a beautiful look, the full of it. Now, when you want to do this, you can also cover it into frames and put it. Or if you want to do these motifs and put it as a fridge magnet or anything, you can do it on the any surface. You can do it on the using acrylic. You can use it on MDF, on plastic, on anything, any lids that are there with you, any covers, caps of waste dabbas or lids of boxes, you can work on that and just put a magnet. This beautiful piece will always be immortalized on the fridge as a magnet. So the announcement of my next workshop, what it is going to be, will be posted on my Facebook. So do follow me on my Facebook page because there that is the first place where we announce, and from there we just start. So all the supplies and all whatever you need to get, we will update you there. From tomorrow, ma'am, from tomorrow, you will. The next sessions will start from Saturday next week. I wish I could take it on the weekdays as well. My weekdays are very busy with my classes. So I only get the time over the weekends to see you all. Now there is one more variation that you do. For hair, like I added these beads, you may just do the hair black and then you may add white dots, and that will serve the same purpose. So then you don't have to be really very careful about these dots, saving the dots and maneuvering your brush around it. So you can just color it, and then later you can. So here, this part is done. I will show you a little with the pen as well, how we do the decoration with the pen. I will erase all the markings that I did and explain you stuff so that we get the final picture look. I would not touch it here right now because my paint is still wet. So I'll not go that high. So this, can we only use black acrylic paint instead of waterproof ink? Yes, you may. If you are doing it on a fabric anyway, you will not be using these pens. It is only flexible when you are doing it on the paper. So waterproof pen only works on the paper. Waterproof like the acrylic pens, you will also get acrylic paint pens that can be used on the fabric or canvas as well. So but if in case you are using it, not the acrylic pens, then you have to use the brush and the acrylic paint. So, yes, like that. Now, if I happen to use the color pens, I will be. So here, likewise, I did in my previous class, in the previous session yesterday, we made this Goddess Lakshmi, and with only the pen, only the colored ink, whatever pen you want to use, you may use, and that is how you can do the line work of it. Okay, and now here I will just do one side with green. Here I'm taking a green pen. Now, this is a uni-ball pen and it is a waterproof pen. So you can do it with Uniball waterproof pen. So green, red, yellow, you get multiple. If in case you are not doing it with this, you have pencil many shades. I'll just show you around how many shades. You get the full box of orange, green, yellow, blue. So these are the colors. I will show you with all of these how it comes out. It's beautiful, but then when you are using your pencil, it is a 0.7 thickness, so it is quite bold and it looks very beautiful. So I'll go ahead and show you. So I'm taking the green and the pink. You may use any color you want. How to do this work? So it's quite relaxing also at the same time. It takes time and patience. So it's not that without any work, there's no gain without any pain. So it's not painful. I would not say it's not pain. It's not painful at all. It's very beautiful and it relieves your stress. Art works are always a stress buster. So practice it like this. You may use very many of them. Here I'm adding this. So 0.7 is a good thickness, and you get bolder lines with this. This how it will get little highlighted. You may or may not fill it. It's up to your wish. Few places you may fill it. Like suppose I'll put the camera down a little, so you would see how I'm working on this. Few portions I may fill it up. The areas are really tiny, and with pen it works fine. Like so. So it'll get the upliftment of this color. Too much of red here. Putting black dots. That's how it is coming. Now just giving just rough lines halfway. These halfway lines will just give you the effect of shade and color, white and pink. So whenever you want a little kick of color, you can just add such kind of details in the this. I hope this is helping you to give you the idea of how the black and white and how the lightly colored will be. You may go ahead and do the, please post the entire picture of colored Lakshmiji. Sure, I will. Pen, tonic, gel pen, any gel pen you can use. If you are not using anything that involves water, then you may use. If you want to do it with this pen and then later want to do the color, then what will happen when your color will touch the pen, it will bleed off. So it will spread. You don't want it to spread. That is how we just create a little bit of effect. That's it. Not too much, but then it gives a very, the look changes automatically. Thank you, Geeta. Thank you. You've always been so supportive. You always, your kind words really mean a lot. Your comments, and you've been a quite regular. So thank you so much. I'll just show you one figure and then so when you do any of the coloring or this with the pen, then you have to see that you are taking alternate stripes. If you're taking alternate stripes, the white will come out beautifully. So here, taking the green, I have green in pencil as well. This is actually a little brighter. So you have beautiful shades in this. Dark green and light green also. So I'll just take a lighter green. A little bit lighter green. These pens were lying with me from a long time. This is only that in Kalamkari I just picked it up. Okay. Now here I'm doing the negative space or the back space, and I'm keeping it white. Here these inside, I'm just filling. These are smaller areas, not very big. So if in case you don't want to use your brush and paint, you can go with this as well. And I'm using only two colors, green and red. So here, I'll just take the green. Just giving one line. You may not want to color the whole thing. Just give a one line in the center and it will give that light shade of green. So this is how the picture comes. And here a little red on the corners of this flower. Just adding it in the corners, so those dots. So this is how the picture comes out to be, and later I will be doing this as well. I think we are just running. Okay, I can actually finish this as well and show you right away how it looks. So here, with this light kind of work, and you do the background with really dark, it'll come out nice. Now here also, giving smaller lines, I'll put it down so that you can see. So it's not only the colors, you can do it with black as well. I'll show you one place. So if you do a little area with black, like this black. It looks as if it's a beaded necklace. You're just going around the line, and you may not be very close to the line, or you have to be really, really careful. Just loosely go around the line. The effects will come out nice because it's a freehand work, and it's not. And your lines will vary a little, and that is okay because. Why is that? When you see Kalamkari, the real Kalamkari, you will see blobs of color which gets blotted on the cloth sometimes. And that is how we actually get to know that it is authentic piece and not printed. So the print, if in case it is a print, it will be perfect. I'm just adding the background lines, not too much of color. You may also add a little curved lines like this. beautiful flower that comes half and half in colors. Here again, I'm just doing the outline, nothing else. And here I'm just adding the color on the tips, so just halfway. So since it is a pen, you don't have to blend any color, you don't have to create. You will have lines and that is good. Here, but this also, I'm giving it a little shade over here, and this is how my picture has come out to be. I hope you all like it. Calligraphy class, yes, actually, I have noted that down. I will be taking the calligraphy class, so please wait. If you want to do it with me, you may also put the message, and I'll clear your doubts on calligraphy. On my Facebook page, I will be doing a class on calligraphy starting November. Okay. So, yeah, thank you so much. I hope you all liked it and I loved it. It's come out beautiful. So, I will see you all next week with a new workshop. And thanks for being here. Any questions or anybody who has missed on asking or doubts may appear later, you may write it to me and I will answer all your questions. So thank you all for being a part of the Kalamkari course and keep in touch with me and we will continue doing more workshops. So, and also I want you all to share it with others as well, because those who want to join, they can come and join. And any doubts, I personally take it and I will be clearing all of it. Thank you. Thank you. So many wishes for a Teacher's Day. Thank you so much. Ganesh. Yeah, happy Ganesh Chaturthi to all. We'll be seeing you on Saturday and Sunday next week. Thank you all. Bye-bye.